Hi, my name is Jason, and today I will be showing you what I believe will be the future of the film industry, and that is virtual reality. I predict that virtual reality will be the way in which people watch movies in the next 10 years. We as people love movies, whether it's for entertainment, education, or to simply get an escape from our daily lives. It's one thing to watch a movie from your couch and to partake as a viewer, but what if you could actually become a part of the movie? What if there was a way to fully immerse yourself in the film that you were watching?
The answer to this is virtual reality. VR would take into account our different senses and be able to expand the way in which we experience the movie. It would be such a more immersive and engaging form of watching movies, enhancing the plot.
I was shocked when I found that there's still a great separation between virtual reality and movies. I thought these two would go hand in hand, and production companies would be jumping on the opportunity to create films for VR headsets. Though production companies have yet to really enter into this market, virtual reality companies have really been jumping on the opportunity to not only provide gaming experiences for users, but to also start creating films within the industry. One of the leaders is Oculus, where they created Oculus Story Studio.
When we started Oculus, we really thought that the major focus for VR was going to be games. Now that the Rift is sort of maturing as a technology, and really virtual reality on the whole, the potential is really there to take people to these virtual worlds.
Possibilities of VR are much more vast than we initially thought they would be, because you matter in that story. The way you experience the story matters. While the way I experience a movie doesn't matter for how the movie is told.
The film industry is constantly looking for ways to evolve and to provide a more immersive and exciting movie experience. Motion pictures date way back to the first black and white film in 1895.
We may recognize the infamous Charlie Chaplin films that became the forefront of the 1920s, using fast-paced skits to provide humor to audiences.
Movies went from short black and white films to full-length feature films. 3D movies then emerged to provide an even more in-depth viewing experience. The film industry has come a long way since then, but lately the growth has felt like it's plateaued.
This plateau has created an opening in the market in the movie industry, as there hasn't been a new technology in quite a few years now that further enhances the movie experience. But I believe virtual reality will be that new innovation that takes the movie industry and the watching experience to that next level. As you can see in this graph, the total hours watched of television within households skyrocketed since its invention in the 1950s. 2007 to 2011 is when we saw the peak of consumption, with over 9 hours watched on average per household. However, we can also see that in the last decade, there has been a steady decline in the hours watched.
I believe that a main reason behind this is people are getting bored of the traditional methods of watching movies.
A recent study found that the average human attention span dropped to 8 seconds, which is less than that of a goldfish. Social media is one reason to blame for this, as we are so used to instant and constant gratification when we scroll. We more recently saw the rise in streaming platforms, allowing for a more comfortable and intimate viewing experience.
Currently, you can download movies to your VR headset through streaming platforms like Netflix or Prime Video. However, currently movies aren't being made specifically for the purposes of virtual reality. When movies start being made for this technology, they'll create a wider view with more peripheral vision to add more depth and layers to the plot that you're seeing.
Storytelling in VR is much more complex. It's kind of a three-dimensional storytelling. There's multiple things going on at the same time.
What would it be like to be in an arena with the matador and the bull as their sparring?
You are seeing that dust get kicked up in your face.
Adrenaline is pumping. You tend to only remember the details that you need to know, and everything else goes fuzzy around you. We're going to embrace that.
Could we build an environment that was so real? Could we really make you feel you're there? Crawling around and getting your head right up close to the plants and really feeling that sense of scale, and then, oh my God, what is that?
This graph here is a visual representation of the acceleration speed of technological adoption of different technologies in the United States. It shows how long it took from when they were first invented to when they reached 50% ownership of the total population. Looking at the TV, it took about 30 years from when it was first invented for it to be owned by 50% of Americans. What's interesting to look at is the accelerated acceptance rate with new innovations. The cell phone became widely used in under 15 years, the internet in under 10 years, and the MP3 player only took 6 years to be owned by 50% of the population. This graph here helps to display that newer technology is being accepted a lot more quickly within society, which helps to prove that virtual reality will most likely be widely used within the next decade. This helps to prove my theory that virtual reality will soon be the new television. In conclusion, I truly believe that virtual reality will take the market by storm over the next decade, and pretty much everyone will own the technology. It will be the new way in which we watch movies, and I'm truly so excited to see how this potential innovation will become a reality.